Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here, and in today's Red Dead Redemption 2 video, we are going to be investigating the town of Pleasant. What happened here? What is inside of that shack that says Stay Out Plague? And solving all the mysteries of this abandoned settlement. So let's start with that. Pleasant is an abandoned settlement in Scarlet Meadows, and it's also a point of interest. And there's a sign on the front that says it was founded in August 1883, which would have been roughly about 15 or 16 years before our story takes place in 1899. Now, if you actually inspect this site, Arthur will write down, "Here's an empty town that I found," and John will say, "I went to an abandoned town." And it seems as if the focus is on these 10 graves that you can find out front. Now, these graves all have one thing in common, which we'll talk about. So the graves are Laura Yeatman, killed by gunshot, September 1883, age 38, a dear wife and mother. Jesse Yeatman, murdered, September 1883, age 14, a tragic loss of a beautiful soul. Asa Hawson, found murdered, September 1883, age 34, beloved mother. Amelia Curl, dead of a gunshot to the head, September 1883, age 66. Reginald Yeatman, killed by gunshot, September 1883, aged 43 years old, loved father and husband. Jimmy Hawson, killed by knife wound, September 17th, 1883, age 15. May he find eternal peace in heaven. Daniel Curley, had his life taken on September 17th, 1883. Glenn Yeatman, killed by knife wound, September 1883, age 15, taken too soon. Curtis Baines, born 1823, murdered September 1883. His love has taken from him by hate. And then Edmund Tobin, born July 1854, killed by gunshot on September 1883, age 29 years old. So did you guys catch on to that? It seems as if everyone who has a gravestone here, all 10 of these people, were either murdered, killed by knife wound, or gunshot. So it sounds like a massacre happened at this town, and all of the dates of those deaths are September 1883, 1 month after the town was founded. So that means things are a little bit spooky and suspicious. The town was founded on August 1883, and then the entire town, or at least 10 of its, I guess, people, were murdered a month later. How does something like that happen? Now, it's unlikely that the whole town was murdered, as someone did put up gravestones, but it is possible that the killings were the reason for this town being abandoned. You would assume that people wouldn't want to live here after a murder like this occurred. So this again raises a lot of questions. Who is the murderer? Why did they do that to the town of Pleasant? And what exactly happened here afterwards? Now, the reason there's such a mystery of this place is there's a big barn or a shack or a little cabin that says Stay Out Plague. And this has prompted a lot of people to wonder, is there something inside that we don't want to find out about? Can we get inside? What if this plague gets out? Is the plague what actually killed all of these people and not necessarily a knife wound or a gunshot wound or something like that? Well, I wanted to investigate every one of these buildings. So the first building I wanted to check out was the one right next to that shack. It seemed like it was a normal house. You aren't able to go inside any of these buildings in Pleasant. So what I did was use the lantern and pistol glitch, and I was able to get inside, and I was kind of shocked that there was an actual interior here. Now, it wasn't much, but we did have like a floor and walls and a ceiling, and there was a fireplace as well. So maybe this is just supposed to indicate that someone at some point in time lived in this house. I mean, it's clearly been abandoned for 15 or 16 years. You can see like the decrepit outside and how nothing seems to be kept up. So that is the first house right there. And then I wanted to move on to the plague barn. Now, this one was giving me a lot more trouble as far as trying to get inside. In fact, I couldn't even manage to get inside using both of the doors. The way this barn is laid out, you've sort of got like the main door, which has the stay out plague written on there. And then there's sort of like a side part of the building that also has like a little door. I'm assuming maybe it's like storage. I couldn't manage to get in either of these ways. I actually had to try going on the side of the building. And even then, I couldn't really get on the inside. I was only able to look on the inside. And unfortunately, there's not anything all that exciting on the inside of this shack. The only thing that's there is, well, nothing. It's just a blank, empty interior. There's nothing that would suggest there's a disease in there. There's nothing that points to like an undead nightmare, either Easter egg or reference or anything like that. It's just simply empty. So if Rockstar does plan on doing anything with this barn, well, then they're probably going to have to add something because there really isn't anything inside that would make us fear the plague. So that's what's on the inside of that abandoned shack. I guess that solves the mystery. I wish it was more exciting, but that's kind of it. Now, I wanted to continue to explore some of the other areas in Pleasance because there was still a ton going on here. The easternmost house of this town also has words painted on it. The first one reads unclean sinners, and then on the door it states ill with sins. So is there something going on here that we don't know about? Like, were the people of Pleasance cursed? Did they commit some giant sin or crime? And that's why the plague came through, and that's why they were all murdered and killed? Again, I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. Maybe you have a better insight or you know something that I don't regarding this mystery and what's going on at the town of Pleasance. But that house is kind of weird how it has that written on the outside. Now, you can also get in on the inside of this house, and it has the exact same interior. So there's nothing on here that really gives away any hints or clues. Now, there is an abandoned schoolhouse in Pleasance that you can find on the opposite side of the street. At least I think it's a schoolhouse. The only thing that's significant in there is you can find a comic book, Otis Miller and the Boy from New York, which I guess you could bring to Jack. There's also a ginseng elixir on the mantle and a cigarette card as well. But there's nothing inside of the schoolyard that gives us any more details, hints, or clues as to what really went on here. And it seems like ever since the murder up until now, Pleasance has just been used for a place for people to stay, drink, and sort of just use as their own trash can. Because all you see are a bunch of like bottles and stuff like that on the ground. And that's about it. Now, there's one final building in Pleasance. There is a big church. It has the exact same interior as all the other buildings we looked at in game. So there's nothing really unique there. Just like all the other buildings in this place, we don't get any hints or clues as to what's going on here. So we can't gather any more information there. The one thing I did find out about this place, I was just doing some experiment, or I wanted to do some experiments with dynamite, is the graves can be destroyed. Now, I should have expected that because I'm sure they were either made of like, you know, soft stone or wood. But if you throw some dynamite on there, you can blow them up and you actually don't get negative honor points for destroying these graves. I wonder why. Almost every single grave that you can desecrate in game, you get negative honor points for it. But this one you don't. So that's kind of strange. I certainly wonder why. There's also an outhouse on the outside of the church. I checked to see if anyone was stuck on the inside, and no one is stuck on the inside. So no one has been in the Pleasance outhouse for like the last 15 years. At least you could say that's a positive. Now, in case you're wondering if the dynamite can be used to open up any of the other buildings or change anything else in the town of Pleasance, well, unfortunately, the answer there is also no. Everything seems to be static here. I wish there was more details on this town. I wish there was like a newspaper article. I wish there was something that would give us details as to what is going on here. On the surface level, it looks like there was a murder and then a plague, but I think something else is going on here. I mean, who would come back and paint all those letters and words on the doors? And who would set up the gravestones? I mean, I feel like there is so much more going on here. I don't understand the motive of what the murder is. I don't know who the murderer is, if we could even find them in game. There's so many questions here, and of course, I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. If you feel like you have a better idea of what's going on at the town of Pleasance or what happened here, Be sure to let us know in the comments down below. We'd love to hear from you guys down there. If you did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new or you like daily Red Dead Redemption 2 videos like this. With all the way, guys, like I said, thanks so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.